chance to prove they are the best. It's the Chiefs going up against the Raiders.
Larry, we have played 266 games in this NFL season. Only one remains, and it's the biggest of them all, as EA Sports is proud to present coverage of the Super Bowl. Tonight, it's all on the line. We play for the Lombardi Trophy. The eyes of the world upon us tonight as Super Bowl 52 from Minneapolis is underway. This one taken from the 7. A bad return here. He gets it out to the 25-yard line. Give him a couple on the carry there. Second and 8. And quickly now, a look at the Kansas City offense.
Spencer was a quintessential one-cut runner. It's an offensive lineman's dream. He presses the line of scrimmage on every run and takes the carry to pile with him.
Here's Smith now on second down. And it's the caught by Travis Kelce. And they get him down. Before it takes it across the 40-yard line. The Kansas City first, Smith finding his fellow Pro Bowler, Kelce.
I do believe we'll see a little bit more of this game progresses, because when you can have that type of a game, the defense, it hurts them in so many ways, because most teams like to be strong down the middle. If you can stay in there, that opens things up for you on the outside as well.
That's where he would be tied in. It's so good, that middle third, the seam routes, the in routes. Yeah, you're right. Probably see more of that.
Yeah, there's a lot of current and fortitude to go in the middle as well.
Now it's Smith. The tight end Kelce has it over the middle. And he'll get it into enemy territory just across midfield at the 49. Now lineup getting 10 back as that sets him up for third down.
A lot of tight ends just use their size and their strength trying to occupy some space to kind of body people away and catch the football. And that's this guy. He's a refined route runner. Makes me wonder if he took some dance classes in his background with his football.
And the penetration too strong. He won't make it back to the line of scrimmage. He'll wind up losing a yard on the play, and it'll be fourth down.
They're trying to run right to the teeth of the defense on third down, but looked like those teeth were pretty sharp.
They were having absolutely none of it. Stopped him for a loss.
Yeah, couldn't get any leverage up front and move people aside in order to run the ball.
So the Raiders backed up here to begin their first drive. Derek Carr, he'll be the one leading the troops. Pro Bowl quarterback, his fourth year now out of Fresno State.
And I remember when he was a prospect coming out of college and people wondering about different parts of his game. Well, all came to Kevin Madsen in 2016. At the Raiders at 11-3, I'm thinking Super Bowl. Before injury finishes season, they're counting on him to take them to new heights.
So one quarter down here in the Super Bowl. 0-0 our score. They're looking at a second and short yardage to start things out. Some room to work. And he'll go down just shy of the 25 at the 24-yard line. Taking matters into his own hands, and he picks up 4 yards and a first down.
Offensively, they like their situation, so they tried to take a shot downfield, but no one was open, so it was tucking in run time, and he picks up a first down.
Throwing now is Carr. And it's hauled in by Jared Carr. Give him a first down, 15 yards that time for the Raiders.
They gave up the completion there, but this is what zone defenses count on. Catching the ball and not much left after the catch.
2 minutes remain in a scoreless first half. A reminder coming up at the intermission. We'll get highlights of the Super Bowl from Larry Ripley and the crew in Orlando with our EA Sports Keep Time Report. Another more on that one and another first down.
So right now what I'm seeing, Usually their offense is just firing off the ball a lot quicker than they can react. And not only that, they're sustaining the blocks, too. I've seen guys get 6-7 yards downfield before there's even a hit to contact.
But he gets this one to Michael Crabtree. And this time he's able to take it down to the 42. 7 yards to pick up on the pitch and catch. On second down, here's Carr. Carr to the middle, and it's incomplete. Jared Cook, the tight end, was the target. And it's third and short.
Tremendous coverage there. Just did not catch the football and complete the interception. But what do they say all the time? If you have really good hands, he'd be playing offense.
Carr. Well, falls incomplete after almost being intercepted. A pick there would have been great. The good news for the defense now, it's fourth down.
But he did almost everything right. Excellent coverage, breaks on the football, just unable to haul it in and take it the other way. So he dropped an interception. The key part now, don't dwell on it. Just move on to the next play.
Here's Carr to throw. Oh, he'll just get rid of this one deep. That's going to be knocked away and incomplete. A gutsy call by Jack Del Rio, but it does not pay off. And the Chiefs defense comes up with a stop. But even though they didn't get it, probably the right call. Too long for a field goal and just not a whole lot to gain for a comeback.
Yeah, you wouldn't really know very much yardage if you punched it out, right? And the thing about a field goal, you know this from so much experience. The longer the field goal, the lower it comes out off the kick, right? Which means it's got a better chance of being blocked. So you're taking a chance either way. I like the fact they went for it. You know the key to a good screen pass is, don't you?
But you're going to tell me, good blocking?
Well, good blocking eventually. The first is get after. You want to let the defenders go past you, leak out to whichever side or even in the middle where you want to set up the screen, and then you do your blocking. How about the read, though, by the defensive guys? They weren't fooled at all and actually ran with the lineman to where the play was and smothered it for a loss of yardage.
Final shot here before break. Smith. So as the set designers rush out here to get us ready for the spectacle. So the halftime show of the Super Bowl abbreviated. Ready to go for the second half. Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number three. Let's just feel it at the goal line. Twisting away. The Raiders offense, they'll go on offense first to start quarter number three. There are 0 points on the scoreboard for either side. It'll be interesting to see what adjustments are made. The defenses have obviously been great.
Something like defense, this is a classic game. This is what you're looking for. But now you're trying to figure out how to gain any type of an advantage on offense. Is it through a big chunk play that you haven't seen before? Or is it just running your regular offense? Running it better, trying to create an opportunity.
Let's see which avenue they'll choose to go down. Hard to throw on second down. Flushed out right. Hard to win in a lot of ways. The scramble there, a perfect example as he gets the first.
Partner, as a quarterback, sometimes you just got to know when the clock has gone off in your head, it's time to go. Tuck it and get all you can.
First down, Carr. He spins free. And he'll be brought down at the 48-yard line. They'll get five out of the scramble. It's second down.
How about a tip of the cap to the defense? They're working against a very mobile quarterback, but all day long they've kept him under wraps. But on that play, they held him to a short game.
Carr gonna throw. Steps away to his left. This inside the 30. The coverage may be too good that time as he breaks away for 19 with his legs and a first down.
But that was man coverage. So once he decides to run with the football, there's no one to account for, and he turns it into a nice game.
Carr Let's give you the flash of light.
Man, defensively, that hurts. They got him out of his rhythm. They had him hemmed in, but somehow he was able to tuck it away and get away for a gain.
Back now here on EA Sports as we are set to bring you the home stretch here, the fourth quarter. Two big plays in succession. Not sure this D knows what hit him, but now they got to get ready. It's first and goal. Here's Cole. That's Cole. Down at the two. Broke through first contact, but ultimately stopped shy of the goal line. Nice gain of eight that time, but second and goal. He's been quiet today in the passing game, just his second catch.
Yeah, people have to come up with schemes to limit him, and what a lot of teams do. Double him, yep, use a linebacker underneath the safety.
For six, touchdown. With the first touchdown of this Super Bowl, and the Raiders are able to cash in for six. So we have a score to report after all.
Well, stop the press. Yeah, I know. I just brought broadcasting 101. I cut in on my 25-play guy. But think about it this way. Morgan, our crack researcher, just handed us a note. We haven't had a scoreless tie in the NFL since 1943. 43.
And we will not have history here in this one, partner. Our first points of the game coming in the fourth quarter.
I don't think that either one of us saw this game unfolding this way when it began.
No, absolutely not. But hey, now it's still just a one-score game, so don't go anywhere. A lot more to play for. Out to kick is Janikowski. This will be fielded at the 8. He'll take this across the 25, couple extra yards up to the 27-yard line. And now here comes Kansas City. And let's see what the defensive coordinator may have up his sleeve here to try to get this final last stand and win this football game. Now first down, Smith. Complete the tight end, Kelsey. And he gets this one just shy of the 40-yard mark and down at the 49. Given 13 yards there in the Kansas City first down. Time for a break. We're back to perhaps crown a champion after this. So the Chiefs in possession of the ball as we welcome you back. They come up on a first and 10, desperately needing a score here on what could be their final drive. Back to Cole. Caught, Kelsey, left side. And the tackle down, but not before he gets in the enemy territory. Given 13 yards there in a Kansas City first down. He's back to Cole. And he can't get Cole off. He's taken down. What a huge play at this point in the game. Clock running here, under 90 seconds to go. He'll talk it over here before what will be an important third down. Good look to throw. He's going to let it fly. And a shot taken on third down, unsuccessful. Fourth down now.
It's another big shot dodged in the defensive. Now just one point completion away from salting away this victory. And I know this feeling. They're almost giddy. They have to stay focused and locked in. They can make one big mistake.
And Wilson has it. And he takes this one down all the way near the 30. Give him 27 yards that time. And the Chiefs are going to have a first down. They'll look to throw. Incomplete, but a penalty flag is down in the backfield. Let's get the call. Through the flag usually always indicates holding, and that's what we've got.
And you know, depending on their positioning, where you are on the field, the umpires get different responsibilities, but always, always making sure that one's holding.
To throw a snip. This time he's got the hookup. It's complained. And they'll be inside the 25 now at the 24. That puts a good dent in their first down setback. It's a pickup of 16. Smith. Yes, he's into the end zone. So they get the late score they needed. And now the extra point can tie this thing up in the final minute. So getting the big touchdown they needed late in the fourth. Now what do? You conserve it and just tie up?
No, I think you put your practice into game situation. Go as fast as possible. You already have your play call ready to go. Go for two and decide it right now.
So that drive in total, 8 plays. And it's capped off with a Kansas City touchdown. On the return, here's a dangerous Cordarrelle Patterson. And he's got some space here. And he's going to wind up bringing this one inside the 45-yard line.
This one must have worried about how they would be after losing their lead. What a big-time return season and not bad.
To throw his car. Eluding the pressure right. And he'll get it inside the 40 to the 39. He'll wind up getting right about 4 there on the scramble. And it's second down.
Well, he's proven real effective running the football. No one open, don't force it. Just get what you can. And that's what he's done very well in this game.
Back to throw. Car. It's open by Lee Smith. And he's going to get this down near the 20-yard line. So 4 quarters wasn't enough, and we are off to overtime. Don't change that dial. Overtime in a playoff game. Awesome setup. Remember, the rules are the same as they would be in the regular season.
That's exactly right, Brandon. Remember, the receiving team, if they score a touchdown, game is over. But if they kick a field goal or don't score, the other team gets a chance to get the football. They get a possession. If they go down and score, they win the football game at that point. If both teams get field goals, we keep playing. If a defense scores, let's say the receiving team gets the ball, doesn't score, or they throw a pick six or fumble, gets picked up, the defense scores, game over. But here's the best part. In a regular season, only one player is playing, we can call it a tie. Here, we're going to play until we have a win.
So now here are the Chiefs as their offense makes their way back out onto the field. They're set for their first drive here in overtime. And this is where the crowd can really become a factor.
They've had to battle it all day, but I know what you're saying. In overtime, that gets doubled, doesn't it? At least, because now the crowd really wants to be involved and help their team. And that first drive can dictate the whole thing, because they know if this team takes it downfield and scores a touchdown, it's game over.
It's been loud in here so far. Trying to run an option right side, Smith. And they get it out just short of the 45 at the 44. It'll be a pickup of 16 and the Chiefs first down.
Look, partner, for a few years there, we thought this read option play was going to take over the whole NFL. It seemed like everyone was using it. But it has been scaled back considerably in the last few seasons, mainly because people worry about their quarterbacks getting hit. But when you call it the right time and you use it properly, you see the type of gains you can get. Nice chunk of yardage there by the quarterback.
15 more there, and they're on a roll. It's another first down. We're seeing Alex Smith here in overtime. Can't help but think back to last year, opening Sunday of the season against the Chargers. He led the Chiefs back from 3 scores down to 4 OT, and he won on a touchdown run.
So there's plenty of history in doing this, but now rising to the moment again. Another overtime situation. It won't be too big for Alex Smith. I think he actually embraces this time of the game.
Pressure, and that's certainly going to be a key to this game going forward. And that time, they were able to get in there and influence the throw. Remember, quarterback's got to get rid of it. They don't have the tough roll, but they can fall back on anything.
And this time, he's going backwards. So after the no gain on the last attempt, here they get him behind the line. He already has 2 sacks to his credit. Now another tackle for loss.
And you know how you can always identify who is supposed to block him? They're the ones heckling up the coast and just got knocked to the ground with the ball. The amount of sacks that they've absorbed in this game is absolutely extraordinary. Let's just face it. This offensive line flat out cannot handle this pass rush. It's been demonstrated time and time again.
Here's Dustin Colquitt now, on for a very important punt here in overtime. That's much too long. That's into the end zone for a touchback. And now here come the Raiders. Their defense did its job, got the stop. All they need is three, and this is over.
Couldn't have done much else other than score themselves and end it. But they turned it back over to them, and now all they need is a field goal to win the game. Excellent job by the defense, and the offense finished things off.
Part one is done, now part two. So they took a shot on first down, but couldn't connect. Now a play fake. Carr steps away. Spin move there before he's taken down. A nice little game. The improv act there, good for nine. And now they'll be looking at a third and short. Third and one.
And we have to give credit to him for buying time and extending the play. But you know, there's really upset defenders on that one. They thought that they had him. Instead, he was thrown into Teflon and got away.
That's incomplete, but there is a flag down. So hang on. A big call coming on third down. So instead of fourth down, first down.
Well, so much for winning the down you put a lot of emphasis on, because third down is key for offense and defense. Instead, you're going to stay on the field and start to do third downs.
They're going to play action here on first down. Oh, he's got a little daylight. And he'll get it down on the play at the 37. The improv on the scramble there gets him six, and it'll be second down.
And that was not a bad scramble there on first down. He didn't force it, nor did he throw it away. He was able to take off, and now he made it a very manageable second and short.
4 yards remaining now on second down. On play action. Now Carr. On the move to his left. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. Given 12 yards that time and an open first down. Offense comes to the line now, first and 10. Now a play fake here on first down. Flush to his right. Open space inside the 10. And eventually brought down, but it's near the 5 at the 6. Another big hitter there. This one good for 18. 2 minutes to go here in overtime. We'll be back after this. Play action. Now it's Carr. He can change the pressure. Now he's going
to get an item.
There's still time to rectify this situation, because the silver lining, they took a sack on first and goal. But that close to the goal line, it still doesn't work.
Yeah!
Touchdown! They win the Super Bowl! The Raiders are on top of the football world. They will hoist the Lombardi Trophy as the Super Bowl champions. Super Bowl champions, they etch their name forever in NFL immortality.
That's pretty phenomenal right there. That actually gave me chills just to hear you say that, because immortality, forever and ever. When you look in the record books, you'll see this team, you'll see their picture, that your name will be a part of it. That's got to be an incredible feeling, because it's been a long journey to get there, and now they get a chance to enjoy it.
And they end this year just how everybody wants to end the year, holding the Lombardi Trophy. What a season for them. What a ride it's been for us as well here in the booth. For Charles Davis and our entire crew, thanks for watching, everybody. We will see you next season right here on EA Sports.